Mary, nice to see you again. How have you been? Good. Today is the sixth Korean class. Wow, our class is already the sixth time. By the last time, one third of the Korean class has already passed. So starting today, I will be explaining a lot about grammar. It may be difficult to learn grammar, but I will teach you, don't worry. Then this time, I will give a class on the subject of Where are we? The first thing we will learn today is these ones. I will read it first. 여기는 어디입니까? 여기는 서울대학교입니다. 저는 외국 학생입니다. 우리는 외국 학생입니다. 선생님은 무엇을 하십니까? 나는 한국어를 가르칩니다. 저는 한국어를 공부합니다. 쌤은 밥을 먹습니다. You may feel a bit difficult because I read it only in Korean. Well, it looks difficult, but I will explain it. Don't worry. The first sentence is 여기는 어디입니까? Last time I explained about subject maker. Do you remember? If you remember subject maker, raise up your hand, please. Okay, so I will explain to you these sentences. So the first sentence is 여기는 어디입니까? 여기 means here. 는 is subject maker. 입니까 means be verb. So 여기는 어디입니까? Means where are we? When you want to know the place where you are, you can use this expression. The next sentence is 여기는 서울대학교입니다. 서울대학교 means Seoul National University. I will tell you about the sentence structure here. In English, sentences are written in the order of subject, verb, object. But in Korean, remember that Korean is written in the order of subject, object, and verb. And I will tell you about the sentence structure we just learned. 엔입니까? And 엔입니다. So N means noun. Just now I told you. N입니까? This one means is this N? And for answer, you can say N입니다. N입니다 means this is N. Since we will continue to use N in the future, remember that when N appears, it is noun. When you ask something, you can just put noun plus 입니까? So instead of N, you can put any noun here. Then shall we look at the third sentence? The third sentence is 저는 외국 학생입니다. And 우리는 외국 학생입니다. So, 저 means I. There are two words for I in Korea. 나, 저. 나 is common one. And when you are younger than someone, we use 저. So, when you meet someone for the first time, it is right to use 저. And I will explain about 는. There are four kinds of subject maker in Korea. Today, I will only tell you about two of them. From now on, we will call ending consonant as 받침. So, you should remember 받침 is ending consonant. So, according to 받침, 은, if the preceding word has a 받침, you can put 은. And if the preceding word does not have a 받침, use 는. So let's go back to this sentence. 외국 means foreign country. 학생 means student. 입니다 means be verb. So this sentence means I am foreign student. Then shall we take a look at 우리는 외국 학생입니다. 우리 means we. So this sentence means we are foreign students. You can put country name instead of 외국. Let's learn Korean pronunciation here and move on to the next one. This one. 외국 학생. When you pronounce this word, you need to be careful. When you're talking about just one student, you can just say 학생. But if 외국 is added in front of 학생, it's not like 외국 학생. You should pronounce 외국 학생. It's natural to read 외국 학생, not 외국 학생. Oh, Korea is different in writing and speaking pronunciation. I think you may feel difficult, but don't worry. I will teach you. Then, shall we move on to the next sentence? This time, I'm going to teach you 저는 한국어를 공부합니다. This sentence means I learn Korean. Let's study the basic grammar related to this sentence. 오케이. Through this sentence, I will tell you the basic grammar structure. This grammar is very important, so mark it important. Okay? Okay. So there are four subject makers and two object makers in Korean. But in this case of subject maker this time, I will explain only two. The subject maker and object maker depend on whether the preceding word has a 받침 or not. If the subject maker has 받침, you can use the subject maker 은, the first one. And if the subject has no 받침, you can use 는. The same goes for the object. If the preceding object word has a 받침, you can use 을. If there is no 받침, you can use 를. And I will tell you about 비읍니다. 비읍습니다. 아, 습니다. If the predicate also depends on whether it is supported by the preceding verb. If the preceding verb has no 받침, write 비읍니다. If the preceding word has a 받침, you can write 씁니다. We don't use the verb as it is in Korean sentence. So original verb should be changed. I think you may feel difficult. Okay, I will explain more and more. So let's practice with the sentences we learned. As I mentioned, with taught, we learned, 우리는 한국어를 공부합니다. In this sentence, there is no 받침 in the subject, 우리. So, 는 is used as the subject maker. The object word 한국어 doesn't have 받침. So, 를 is used as the object maker. In the case of 공부합니다, 공부하다 is the original verb. So, if you minus 하다 from original verb, 공부 remain. 공부 here. 공부 doesn't have 받침. So you can put form 비읍니다. Then it becomes 공부합니다. That's why the sentence 우리는 한국어를 공부합니다 is completed. Okay. And the next sentence is 샘은 밥을 먹습니다. The meaning of this sentence is Sam eats his meal. So Sam given here, Sam given here, does the subject have a 받침 or not? Raise up your hand. So 밥, this object has 받침. So you should put 을. Then you can say 밥을. And in the case of 먹습니다, verb eat in Korea is 먹다. This is the original verb. 먹다 has no 받침. Then it goes like 샘은 밥을 먹습니다. It might be confusing, but we will make you a list of original verbs. And if you continue to study while watching this video, even after this class is over, you will understand. Got it? So the fourth sentence is 선생님은 무엇을 하십니까? The honorific maker is used here, which is very important. You should mark it. So in English, the honorific titles is not that strong or not. But if you talk to someone who is older than you, in official way, you need to use honorific titles. 선생님 means teacher. Teacher is a person who should be respected by others. So when you call teacher, you call Mr. or Miss. But in Korea, when you call teacher, you should call as 선생님. 선생님. So if I ask someone who is older than me, put verb plus 십니까? So just now I talked about verb plus 십니까? And I will explain about this grammar. When there is 받침, you should put 시. And when there is no 받침, you should put 으시. So for this one, 비읍니다. This one is just answer and 비읍니까? 비읍니까? This one is question. 선생님은 무엇을 하십니까? This time I want to answer about this question. So I want to answer like this. 나는 한국어를 가르칩니다. It means I teach Korean. 나 means I, 한국어 means Korean, 가르칩니다 means teach. So, I will explain about 무엇을 읽으십니까? So 무엇을 읽으십니까? Means what are you reading? So 무엇? 무엇 has 받침? So you should put 을. And well, let's see. 읽으십니까? When what 무엇을 읽으십니까? Means what are you reading? So when 다 is omitted from the basic verb of to read, only 읽다 remains. 읽다 has a base. If there is a base, 읽습니다 is added together. It becomes 무엇을 읽으십니까? 나는 한국어를 가르칩니다. It means I teach Korean and just I say 나 means I, 한국어 means Korean, 가르칩니다 means teach. 한국어 means Korean, so it is object maker. Since there is no 받침, you should put 를. Wow, for me also it's difficult to teach Korean grammar, and I understand your heart that it's somehow difficult to learn Korean grammar. But don't worry too much, because it's your first time learning grammar properly, right? And we will upload this video to YouTube, so you can watch it again, okay? So don't be worried. thank you my student. I can see that you are wondering, for today I'm teaching Korean alone, right? You are wondered, right? No way. In fact, a friend was waiting for class with me. The friend who will come out from today is a friend who will become a member of Korean class during the first K-Leaders course program. So I will call him. Sam, come out!
Hi! Hello!
I think he feels shy.
Hello! My name is Sam. Starting from this week, I started talking Korean class together. Nice to meet you!
Oh, good! I can see many friends are greeting him. Thank you so much. Now, Sam and I are going to visit several places. Sam, are you going to ready? Are you ready to go play?
Of course.
Then, let's go! Ba-bam! Hello again!
Hello. 여기는 어디입니까?
여기는 학교입니다.
학교입니다.
Yes, 학교 means school. Okay, then shall we move on to the next place? Ba-bam!
여기는 어디입니까?
여기는 집입니다.
집입니다.
Yes. Now we are at home. home means...
Very good.
Yeah, I think he likes home very much. home means 집. So what is the meaning of the sentence I just said? Raise up your hand if you know the answer. Just now, I said we are at home. The meaning of this sentence is we are at home. Sorry. Yes. Then let's move on to the next place. Ba-bam.
여기는 어디입니까?
여기는 공원입니다.
공원입니다.
Yes. Now we are now in 여의도 한강 park.
아, 여의도 한강 park.
You know 여의도 한강 park? It's very famous and hot place for Korean teenagers.
Come here.
Come. If you spread the mat here and eat chicken, it tastes really sweet. Oh, this time is not for this time. The 공원 means park.
Park.
So what is the meaning of the sentence? 여기는 공원입니다.
여기는
Raise
공원입니다.
Your hand.
Meaning.
So just now we say 여기는 공원입니다.
여기는 공원입니다.
So the meaning of that sentence is we are at park. Okay, let's move on to the next place. 빠밤.
오, 여기는 어디입니까?
나마스테.
나마스테.
여기는 인도입니다.
여기는 인도입니다.
인도 means India. So just now I said 여기는 인도입니다. Who knows the answer, the meaning of this sentence? Just now we say 여기는 인도입니다.
여기는 인도입니다.
So it means we are at India. Instead of 인도, you can say by putting the names of various countries like this.
Everyone did a good job talking today's class.
Yes, Steph, and you should study again when we learned today after class. And if there is something you don't know, you should ask to your teacher. Oh, and homework. You know, you have to work it hard, right? Next week, we will come back with a more fun class.
More fun class.
More fun class. Then see you next week. Bye-bye.